What has been previously known about osimertinib was that the drug was associated with a very high response rate and progression-free survival in the T790M positive group, therefore describing an overwhelming benefit for the drug without a head-to-head comparison with the standard of care. So there is added information coming from this study. This is what the FDA calls a confirmatory study, which is absolutely necessary for full approval of the drug. So we have new information that should be compelling to physicians and should be a deterrent against complacence in terms of testing. If you know that your patient can derive this degree of benefit from osimertinib therapy, then I presume that would be an impetus for every oncologist to test their patients upon failure of the first generation EGFR TKI, because the treatment is really superior.
Yes. And so even though the drug has been available for routine US practice for a little more than a year now, is it your perception that it hasn't really fully penetrated into routine practice up till now, that people were awaiting these results?
That is correct. And I think also what has not penetrated in routine practice is the routine testing looking for the T790M. And that's absolutely necessary. We want to be prescribing the drug for the right patient, because that's the patient that's going to derive the benefit. So I think these results, although not totally new to the community, not totally new to the U.S. oncology population and physicians, it actually confirms and makes the results even more compelling. The FDA has also approved the test along with the therapy to test for the T790M. So the oncologist has an opportunity to either test this in tumor tissue or to test it in plasma. And the test is readily available.
What the possible prospects are for using it as a first-line agent?
So the clinical trial is called FLORA, and it is randomizing patients to either the new second-line standard of care, osimertinib, or the old standard of care, first-generation EGFR TKI. If the study is positive, then we will have a new standard of care declared for first-line therapy. And that means that the majority of the patients diagnosed with this disease, with EGFR mutations, will be switching from the old standard of care to osimertinib, and therefore we will have to change the sequence of our therapies.
And the results of that trial are expected when?
Sometime in 2017.
And it would be part of the trial design, is you were identifying upfront again that the patient you're targeting the osimertinib to remains a patient with a mutation in the with the T790M mutation, is that correct?
No, the eligibility criteria for this clinical trial are any sensitizing EGFR mutation. Mm. So the drug is mutation selective for both EGFR sensitizing mutations, the exon 19 deletion, the L858R, as well as the T790M resistance mutation.